Welcome to the National Science and Math Week.
Salma?
5.4 watts.
You're right.
Heaving function.
You're right. KNUST Senior High School. Congratulations on winning the contest. Welcome to the National Science and Math Quiz. Today we bring you the 16th 1A stage contest in the 2016 edition of the competition. The contest features Anglican Senior High School, Tamale Senior High School, and Armed Forces Senior High Technical School. Anglican Senior High School. Anglican Senior High School is represented by
Egan Mike, your final year.
Ankuma Dennis, final year.
You are very welcome, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
How are you?
You are doing great. What about you?
Oh, I'm doing well. Thank you for asking. All right. You are a cedar school?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So last year, how did it go for you?
Well, we managed to qualify our first contest, but unfortunately for us, we were eliminated by university practice.
Oh.
But this year, with the strength of God on us, we are moving straight to take the trophy.
In that case, let me wish you well.
Thank you, madam.
Next is Armed Forces Senior High Technical School. Armed Forces Senior High Technical School is represented by
Abete Mosizike, your final year.
Osaisa Pomprince, final year.
You're welcome, gentlemen.
Thank you, madam.
And how are you?
We are very fine.
Wonderful. You came from the prelims.
Yes, madam.
How did that go?
Well, we met Krobo Girls and Press B Tamale. Unfortunately, we are not able to come out successful, but we were part of the highest scoring losing schools, of which we came out with the highest points. So
you must have plans for us today.
Well, we have realized that you can't change what happened yesterday, but you can do something today that will change tomorrow, because victory is coming from there.
That's very true, very true. Best wishes to you.
Thank you, madam.
Tamale Senior High School. Tamale Senior High School is represented by
Hadi Abdulkarim Mohammed.
La Dominic Yobat Fanaye.
You are all very welcome, gentlemen.
Thank you, madam.
You seem rather sober. Oh, that's your game face. Okay, I got a smile there. All right. How did you get to this year's contest? Prelims, how did it go?
At the prelims, we met Bengum Senior High School and Nkrofu Agri Senior High School. And we sailed through successfully.
All right.
Yes.
And today's plans?
And today, last year at the one at the prelim, we were kicked off by our brothers, that's Balagatanga Senior High School. Mm-hmm. And today we are here to turn the table around.
Okay.
Yes.
Great. Then let me wish you well. Best wishes.
Thank you.
Contestants are ready. Everybody is going to win today. But before I sit down to begin, let me acknowledge that the National Science and Math Quiz is proudly brought to you by Primetime Limited. We are sponsored by the Ghana Education Service through the Conference of Heads of Assisted Secondary Schools. We are also supported by RMG Ghana Limited, a leading agro input company. I am grateful to GTP for my outfit. Thank you. My name is Dr. Elsie Efa Kaufman. I am a senior lecturer in the Department of Biomedical Engineering, University of Ghana. I'm your quiz mistress. Contestants, the contest comes to you in 5 rounds. The first round is a round for fundamental concepts. Simple, direct questions requiring simple, direct answers from you. If you answer your major question correctly, 3 points. If the question is incorrectly answered, it becomes available for the two other schools to ring for. Once a school rings and answers correctly, a bonus point. If the answer is incorrect, it fetches a penalty point. For questions that require calculations, you have 30 seconds in which you can present an answer. If there are no calculations, you have 10 seconds to do so. All questions are to be attempted once only. Best wishes to all three schools. I'll be starting with armed forces. But before I come to you, I have a preamble to all schools. And this first set of questions will take 30 seconds of your time. Preamble. Factor the binomial as a difference of two squares. That's the preamble. I hope you got it. All right. Armed forces. 6x squared minus 25y. It's your hand up, Sapon. Go ahead.
It cannot be a difference of two squares.
Yes, it can. For a bonus. Hadi or Dominic.
Into bracket, root 6x plus 5 root y, multiply another bracket, root 6x minus 5 root y.
Okay. But you need to be very careful, though. All right. Anglican, with the same preamble. X minus 36y. Yes, Ankuma.
In one bracket, root x minus 6 root y, multiplying in another bracket, root x plus 6 root y.
You are right. And I like the way you presented that answer. Your major question, Tamale. X minus y. Yes, Hadi.
In one bracket, root x minus root y. Multiplying another bracket, root x plus root y.
Yes. What physical quantity is represented by the slope of a velocity time graph? Yes, Apon.
Linear acceleration.
2 out of 3. Doesn't necessarily have to be linear acceleration. What is the nature of the motion of an object in the horizontal portion of its displacement time graph? Yes, Ankuma.
Constant displacement.
2 out of 3. The body is at rest. Yes, it's constant displacement, but it's at rest. It's a simpler way of presenting the whole thing. All right. Tamale. What is the nature of the motion of an object in a straight portion of its velocity time graph? Yes, Hadi.
constant velocity, and at that time the acceleration is zero.
I'm not accepting it for a bonus. This is constant acceleration. Please, the zero acceleration case is a special case. So it's constant acceleration or uniform acceleration. One postulate of the kinetic theory of gases or matter states that gases are composed of molecules whose size is negligible compared to the average distance between them. Give two implications of this postulate. Sapon.
This implies that the intermolecular force of attraction between the molecules is negligible. And also, since the space between them is negligible, they occupy a volume which is considered to be negligible.
That doesn't make sense for a bonus. Oh, you could have told me four things very clearly. Gas can be regarded as though it's made up of point particles. That's one implication. Most of the volume occupied by the gas is empty space, another one. The volume occupied by the gaseous molecules can be ignored. You were confused about that. And gases can be compressed easily. Any two of those would have been fine. Anglican. Another postulate of the kinetic theory of gases or matter states that molecules move randomly in straight lines in all directions at various speeds. Please give the main implication of this postulate. Yes, Ankuma.
Brownian motion and diffusion.
No, for bonus. Sapon.
This implies that the molecules can occupy any free space available.
No, that's not the implication, no. The main implication of this is that any property such as pressure that depends on movement of molecules will be the same in all directions. That's the implication of this one. Tamale, state the postulate of the kinetic theory of matter that is about intermolecular forces. Yes, Hadi.
The postulate states that the intermolecular force of attraction between gaseous molecules is negligible compared to the volume of the containing vessel.
I'm not going to accept it for a bonus. Okay. It's not only about attraction. It could also be repulsion, right? So the forces of attraction or repulsion between two molecules, these are the intermolecular forces, in a gas are very weak or negligible, except when they collide. When they collide, you have an exception. So that is what I was expecting. Armed forces. How does chewing of food help to speed up digestion? Yes, Sapon.
Chewing of food breaks down complex and larger food molecules into smaller particles, thereby increasing the surface area for enzyme reaction.
Yes. Anglican, what is the function of bile in digestion? Yes, Ankuma.
Bile emulsifies fat.
Yes. What class of food is partially digested in the stomach? Yes, Hadi.
Protein.
You are right. Solve the exponential equation. That's the preamble. I hope you got it. All right. Armed forces. 3 raised to the power 9x is equal to 1 over 27. Yes, Sapon.
X is equal to minus 1 over 3.
Yes. Anglican, with the same preamble, 125 to the power x is equal to 1 over 25. Ankuma?
S equals minus 2 over 3.
Yes. 4 raised to the power 6x is equal to 1 over 64. Dominic.
X equals to negative 1 over 2.
Yes. The velocity ratio of a simple machine is 10. Find the distance moved by the load when the effort moves 20 centimeters. Sapon.
2 centimeters.
You're right. Anglican. Determine the mechanical advantage of a simple machine with a velocity ratio of 20 and an efficiency of 80%. Yes, Ankoma.
16.
You're right. Tamale, the mechanical advantage of a simple machine is 0.4. Find the effort required to overcome a load of 100 newtons. Dominic.
250 newton.
You're right. Two half cells, A plus slash A and B plus slash B, have standard electrode potentials, negative 0.50 and positive 0.70 volts, respectively. If the two are to be constituted into a primary cell, what would be the cell reaction and the corresponding EMF? Sapon, it's your hand up. Go ahead.
The possible reaction will be A plus B plus mapping to A plus plus B. And the electro potential is 1.20 volts.
You're right. Two half cells, C2 plus slash C and D plus slash D, have standard electrode potentials, negative 0.30 and negative 0.80 volts, respectively. If a primary cell is constructed with the two half cells, what will be the initial EMF and the cell reaction? Yes, Ankoma.
The cell reaction is C2 plus plus 2D plus C2 plus plus 2D, mapping onto 2D plus plus C plus. And the EMF is 0.50 volts.
I'll give you one for the EMF. One. The cell reaction, 2D plus C2 plus, going to 2D plus plus C. And of course, the EMF is 0.50 volts, as you said. Tamale, carefully. Two half cells, E plus slash E and F plus slash F, have standard electrode potentials, negative 1.10 and negative 0.45 volts, respectively. If a cell is made from the two half cells, what will be the initial EMF and the cell reaction? Dominic.
The cell reaction is F plus plus E going to E plus plus F, and the initial EMF is 0.95 volts.
2 out of 3. The cell reaction was right. The initial EMF is 0.65 volts. What role do the following organisms play in the nitrogen cycle? That is the preamble. Did you get it? All right. So now, armed forces. Nitrifying bacteria. Yes, Apon.
They convert nitrogen from the atmosphere to nitrite.
That's incorrect. For a bonus. Oh. They convert ammonia and other nitrogenous substances into nitrates. Anglican, denitrifying bacteria. Yes, Ankuma.
Madam, they convert nitrates in the soil into nitrogen gas, which escapes freely into the atmosphere.
Yes. Nitrogen fixing bacteria. Yes, Hadi.
Madam, they convert free nitrogen in the atmosphere and convert them into nitrates into the soil.
Yes. And that's the end of the first round.
Welcome to the Good Life of Agriculture with RMG Ghana Limited. Experience our quality crop protection products, seeds, fertilizers, irrigation equipment, and technical expertise to increase your yield. RMG Ghana Limited, agriculture on a sustainable basis.
At the end of the first round, Armed Forces Senior High Technical School has 13 points. Anglican Senior High School has 18 points. Tamale Senior High School has 18 points. Let me encourage all to keep working hard. Round two. This is a round which is also known as the speed race. In this round, questions are thrown to all three schools simultaneously. To have an opportunity to answer a question, you need to ring your bell. May I hear your bell, Anglican? Thank you. Yours, Armed Forces. Thank you. And yours, Tamale. Thank you. When you ring, the answer must be ready. Now, if you're able to successfully answer the question on the first attempt, 3 points. On the second attempt, 2 points. On the third attempt, a point. For questions that require calculations, you have a maximum of 30 seconds to present that answer. If there are no calculations, you have a maximum of 10 seconds. Best wishes to all three schools. The first set of questions will require a maximum of 30 seconds. First question. The gravitational force between two protons, 2 femtometers apart, is about 5 × 10⁻¹⁵ newtons. What is the gravitational force between 2 protons, 2 nanometers apart?
Minus 5 × 10⁻²⁰.
That's incorrect. Which of you? Ankuma.
5 × 10⁻¹⁸ newtons.
No. Dominic.
5 × 10⁻¹⁷ newtons.
No. The right answer, 5 × 10⁻⁷ newtons. Next question. A 5-watt automotive lamp is operated at a potential difference of 12 volts for 200 seconds. Find the energy consumed by the lamp. Yes, Ankuma.
120,000 joules.
That's incorrect. Dominic.
12 kilojoules.
No. Yes, Sapon.
2.4 kilojoules.
No. The right answer is 1,000 joules or 1 kilojoule. Next one. A constant 500 Newton force acts on a stationary body for 100 seconds. What is the power developed by the force? Which of you, Ankuma?
0 watts.
Yes. Which of the radioactive emissions or radiation has the most penetrating power?
gamma.
Yes, Hadi.
Gamma radiations.
Yes. Which of the radioactive emissions or radiation has the highest ion? Yes, Ankuma.
Alpha particle.
Yes. Which of the radioactive emissions or radiation is not affected? Yes, Hadi.
Gamma radiations.
Yes. Evaluate the determinant of the 2x2 matrix with elements 2, 2, 2, 2. Yes, Hadi.
Zero.
Yes. A car is sold for 36,000 Ghana cedis at a profit of 20%. Find the profit. Yes, which of you? Ankuma. Ankuma.
Madam, 7,200 cedis.
Yes, Amos.
720 Ghana cedis.
No. Dominic.
72,000 Ghana cedis.
No. The right answer is 6,000 Ghana cedis. If cosine of x is equal to 1/3, evaluate cosine of x squared plus sine of x squared. Hadi.
1.
Yes. Name the site of glycolysis. Yes, Ankuma.
The cytoplasm.
Yes. Why should a farmer who is interested in the production of seeds spray an insecticide on his crops only when bees are not around? Yes, Hadi.
Madam, this is because bees are agents of pollination. So he need to spray when bees are not around so that he will not kill these agents. When he spray when they are around, it will kill them. And hence, when his crops are ready for pollination to take place.
Yes. Yeah. Name the site of the Krebs cycle. Yes, Dominic.
In the matrix of the mitochondria.
Yes. That's the end of the second round. At the end of the second round, Armed Forces Senior High Technical School has 13 points. Anglican Senior High School has 27 points. Tamale Senior High School has 36 points. Round 3. This round has our problem of the day. The problem of the day is a single question to all three schools. From the time I ask you to begin, you will have 3 minutes to present a single answer from your school. The problem of the day is worth 10 points. Now, let's turn over our sheets and read the problem of the day together. Problem of the day. Find the stationary points of the curve y is equal to x to the power 4 plus 4x cubed minus 6 and distinguish between them. Contestants, this is your problem of the day. You may now begin. stop writing and present your answers. Contestants, please pick up your notepads and present them on the boards. This is 12. The contestants have presented their answers. Before we award the marks, let's look at the suggested solution from our consultants. This is a problem in mathematics. So we have a curve. Y is equal to x to the power 4 plus 4x cubed minus 6. That's the curve. And what we are supposed to do is to find the stationary points of the curve and then distinguish between them. So first find the stationary points, those will be coordinates, then we distinguish whatever type of stationary points that they are. All right, in order to find the stationary points, we need to differentiate this equation of the curve. So dy dx is equal to 4x cubed plus 12x squared, and then we set that to 0 to find the stationary points. If we do that, we can actually factorize this to 4x squared multiplied by x plus 3, which is equal to 0. And so if we solve for x, we get x is equal to 0 or negative 3. 2 points for doing this. Now let's take the point that has x coordinate equals 0. If we substitute 0 into the original equation of the curve, we get y to be negative 6. And so the point, that point, is 0, negative 6. 2 points for this. Now, for the point that has x coordinate negative 3, again, we substitute negative 3 into the original equation of the curve, and we get y is equal to 81 minus 4 times 27 minus 6. We get 81 minus 108 minus 6, and this gives negative 33. So the second point has coordinates negative 3, negative 33. 2 points for this. All right. Then we move on. We need to distinguish between them. So we now have two stationary points. One with coordinates 0, negative 6, and the second one with coordinates negative 3, negative 33. What types of stationary points are they? So we take the second differential of the equation. So we get d squared y dx squared is equal to 12x squared plus 24x. Now let's look at them individually. When x is equal to 0, the first point, d squared y dx squared, we substitute 0 into the second differential, and we get 0. And so the point 0, negative 6 is a point of inflection. So you have to interpret what you get. So it's a point of inflection. For this correct interpretation, 2 points. Now we do the same for the second point. When x is equal to negative 3, d squared y dx squared is equal to 12 multiplied by 9 minus 24 multiplied by 3, and this is 108 minus 72, and this gives 36, positive 36, which is obviously greater than 0. So the interpretation is that the point negative 3, negative 33 is a minimum point. 2 points, giving a total of 10 points. This is the suggested solution from our consultants. Contestants, honestly, I was expecting perfect scores all around for this. I was surprised at what you were able to do or not able to do. Tamale, you started out by realizing that to find the stationary point, you must differentiate. So you differentiated and then you got values of x, the correct ones, 0 and negative 3. So that is 2 points for you. Beyond that, everything else went downhill. Even differentiation, the second differential is wrong. And so I'm giving you 2 out of 10. Anglican, you also realized you had to differentiate. You got that differentiation right. You got the two x coordinates right. 2 points there. And then the substitution. You got the right coordinates for y, for the first one, when x is equal to 0. So you have 0, negative 6. That got you 2 more points. The one for x equals negative 3, something went wrong with your math. And so you were not able to get that. Then to distinguish them, the 2 points, you realized that you had to do a second differential. You were able to differentiate correctly, right? So you have the second differential, right? I'm giving you 1 point for that. But then you were not able to proceed to go on and clearly interpret what you were looking at. And so that gives you 5 out of 10. Armed forces. You have the points, the x coordinates of the points, 2 points. You were able to get the first point, 0, -6. That's another 2 points. Then you did the calculations for the second point. You, in fact, have the right x coordinate at first, but I don't know what happened when you had to put the coordinates down. You forgot the negative sign. So you are telling us it's 3, -33. No, it's -3, -33. For the right calculation there, I'm giving you 1 point. Then you were able to do the second differential correctly. You did the second differential correctly, so you differentiated correctly. That was worth 1 point. But then you didn't go on to interpret correctly. No. In fact, you are talking about a maximum point. No. So that gives you 6 out of 10. That's the end of the problem of the day and the end of round 3. Round 4. In this round, I'm going to present you with statements. When you receive your statement, please consider the statement carefully and let me know whether it's true or false. If you are right, 2 points. If you are incorrect, you lose a precious point. You may choose not to respond, in which case that statement becomes available to the two other schools. When a school rings and answers correctly, 2 full points. If the answer is incorrect, it fetches the penalty point. Best wishes to all 3 schools. I'm starting this time with Anglican, your statement. The change in kinetic energy of a particle equals the net work done by the forces acting on it. Yes, Michael.
It's true.
Yes. Tamale. The net work done by the forces of friction acting on an object increases the kinetic energy of the object. Yes, Dominic.
It's false.
You're right. Armed forces. Only the component of the net force parallel to the displacement of an object can change the kinetic energy of the object. Yes, Amos.
It's false.
Oh, that's a true statement. In bryophytes, vegetative reproduction is common, whereas the asexual reproduction is absent. Yes, Michael.
It's false.
Oh. That's a true statement. Chlorophyll is the predominant pigment in bryophytes. Yes, Dominic?
It's false.
Oh, it's a true statement. The plant body of bryophytes is always multicellular. No unicellular forms are present. Yes, Apong?
False.
Ah, it's a true statement. When oxygen gas is prepared in the laboratory and collected over water, the gas collected is always a mixture. Yes, Michael?
It's true.
Yes. The actual pressure of oxygen gas collected over water is the total pressure less the vapor pressure. Dominic?
It's true.
Yes. The value of the vapor pressure is independent of the temperature of the water. Amos?
It's false.
You're right. In a rhombus, the diagonals are congruent. Yes, Michael?
It's false.
You're right. In a rectangle, the diagonals are congruent and perpendicular. Yes, Hadi?
It's false.
You're right. Armed forces. In a square, the diagonals are congruent and bisect each other perpendicularly. Yes, Sapon.
It's true.
Yes. The coulomb is the SI unit of electric charge and is one of the base units in the SI system. Yes, Michael.
It's false.
You're right. The ampere is the SI unit of electric current and is a derived unit, 1 ampere being equal to a charge flow rate of 1 coulomb per second. Yes, Dominic?
It's false.
You're right. The SI unit of electric power is the watt, and it is a derived unit, 1 watt being equal to 1 kilogram meter squared per second cubed. Yes, Amos?
It's true.
Yes. When the ciliary muscles of the eye contract, the eye lens contracts. Yes, Michael?
It's false.
You're right. When the ciliary muscles of the eye contract, the eye lens rotates. Yes,
it's
Dominic?
False.
Yes. When the ciliary muscles of the eye contract, the eye lens is rounded. Yes, Apong?
False.
Oh, it's a true statement. Among chemical reactions, we can have static and dynamic equilibrium processes. Yes, Michael?
True.
No. Tamale? For a dynamic equilibrium, there is constant change in reactant and product concentrations. Yes, Dominic?
It's false.
Yes. If an equilibrium reaction is made up of two series of equilibria, the overall equilibrium constant could be the ratio of the two equilibrium constants. Yes, Amos.
It's true.
Oh, no. It's actually a product of the two constants. You multiply them. You don't find a ratio. Anglican, the function y is equal to 2x plus 3 has a stationary point. Michael?
It's false.
You're right. The function y is equal to x squared has a maximum point. Yes, Dominic?
It's false.
Yes. Last statement. The function y is equal to x cubed has a minimum point. Amos.
It's true.
Oh. That's a false statement. And that's the end of the fourth round. At the end of the fourth round, Armed Forces Senior High Technical School has 20 points. Anglican Senior High School has 42 points. Tamale Senior High School has 51 points. Fifth and final round. In this round, I'm going to be reading out clues. Your objective is to solve the riddles. If you solve the riddle on the first clue, 5 points. On the second clue, 4 points. On the third or any clue thereafter, 3 points. In order to solve a riddle, you must alert me. You do so by ringing your bell. May I hear yours, Anglican? Thank you. Armed Forces. Thank you. And yours, Tamale? Thank you. When you ring, the answer must be ready. There are 4 riddles. First one. I am a type of motion that can occur on a straight line as well as on a curve. My distinguishing feature is a linear relation between acceleration and displacement. If I am periodic, then who am I? Yes,
simple harmonic motion.
You are right. I read all the clues, 3 points. I belong to a class of organic compounds. Despite the fact that I belong to a class of organic compounds, I am sometimes referred to as a derivative of another class of compounds. I am sensitive to both mineral acids and alkali. I am hydrolyzed by mineral acids to give 2 neutral molecules, A and B. A gives effervescence with NaHCO3, and B evolves hydrogen.
Estes.
Yes, Apong.
Estes.
No. Yes, which of you? Hadi.
What do we need to say?
Hadi.
Yes. Alkal alkanes.
No. Anglican, I continue. B evolves hydrogen with sodium metal. While A has 4 carbons in a straight chain, B has only 1 carbon. So who am I? Whose hand is up? Yes, Michael.
Proteins.
Oh. Anyone? Anyone, are your hands up? This is methylbutanoate. I have long played an important role in human societies. In object-oriented programming, I am the ability to derive new classes from existing classes. Mind you, I should not be confused with subtyping. In law, I am the hereditary succession to an estate title, etc. I am the process of genetic transmission of traits from parents to offspring. Yes, which of you? Yes, Michael?
Hereditary.
No.
Inheritance.
Yes, Hadi?
Inheritance.
You are right. That was the fifth and final clue, 3 points. Last riddle. I am a 3-digit number. I lie between 100 and 200. I am an exact square. I am an even number. Yes, Dominic.
196. 196.
Yes, you're right. That was the fourth clue, 3 points, and that's the end of the fifth round. At the end of the contest, here are the final scores. Armed Forces Senior High Technical School has 23 points. Anglican Senior High School has 42 points. Tamale Senior High School has 57 points. Armed Forces Senior High Technical School, thank you for being here. Best wishes to you. Anglican Senior High School, thank you for being here and for giving us a good contest. Unfortunately, we must say goodbye. All the best. Tamale Senior High School. Finally, I get a smile. Congratulations on winning the contest. Please prepare well, and I shall look forward to seeing you in the quarterfinals. Viewers, thank you for joining us for this contest. We are still at the 1A stage of competition. Next time, we'll bring you Ghana Senior High School, Koforidua, Okuiapeman Senior High School, and Benkum Senior High School. Before we leave, I would like to acknowledge that the National Science and Math Quiz is brought to you by Primetime Limited. We are sponsored by the Ghana Education Service through the Conference of Heads of Assisted Secondary Schools. We are also supported by RMG Ghana Limited, a leading agro-input company. Thank you for joining us and see you next time. Bye.